Very good morning to all. This is Mr. Suman. Welcome to Suman Education Academy. Hope you all are doing great. So in today's class, I will continue fluid mechanics and hydraulic machines. From this subject, one of the very, very important topic is hydraulic turbine. So before talking about the hydraulic turbine, we must have a clear knowledge about fluid machine. So let us have a small discussion on fluid machine. Fluid machine. So fluid machine is a system. So this machine can convert stored energy in fluid, stored energy in fluid to the mechanical energy, to the mechanical energy. It also converts mechanical energy into stored energy in fluid. So give me a second, let me complete the figure. So this is stored energy in fluid, and then here we have mechanical energy. So the fluid machine, as I was mentioned, the fluid machine, it converts stored energy in fluid into mechanical energy. It also converts mechanical energy into stored energy. And very important note, that is this mechanical energy, which is very, very important in future as well as, and currently also we are using the mechanical energy, especially for generating the electricity. And partially the mechanical energy, which is used in some different applications, but maximum mechanical energy, which is required for generating the electricity. And even today also, we are mostly using this mechanical energy for generating the electricity in different power plants. Right? So here, so what is a fluid machine here? The fluid machine, it can convert stored energy in fluid into the mechanical energy, and mechanical energy into the stored energy in fluid. And here, what is stored energy in fluid and what is mechanical energy? That we have to discuss now. That means the nature of the stored energy in fluid. So what is the nature of the stored energy in fluid? So nature of the stored energy in fluid. So already we had a very clear discussion in lesson one, that is fluid statics. That is the fluid at rest as well as in motion, right? So here, the fluid, when it is at rest, so fluid at rest and the fluid in motion. The fluid in motion. So this fluid at rest, where so this is a little important topic only. So this fluid at rest, where you know the intermolecular energy presents, intermolecular energy and potential energy. Potential energy. So there are two energies. One is intermolecular energy and potential energy, which are present in fluid at rest. So fluid in motion. So here we have different energies which are present in fluid in motion. So here, let me write, there will be an intermolecular energy. Intermolecular energy, potential energy, so these two energies which are already there in fluid at rest, again these two energies which are present in fluid in motion also, and kinetic energy, that is called velocity, kinetic energy, and also pressure energy, that is called flow work. Pressure energy, so which is called what? Flow work. So here kinetic energy is nothing but velocity. Velocity. So kinetic energy, that is called velocity energy. So here, what is the nature of the stored energy in fluid? So this fluid, it may, when it is at rest, so there, you know, intermolecular energy and potential energies are present. And when it is in motion, their intermolecular energy, potential energy, kinetic energy, as well as pressure energy also present in this fluid in motion. So this is about the stored energy in fluids. So what about the mechanical energy? So nature of the mechanical energy. So let us have a discussion about nature of the mechanical energy. Nature of the mechanical energy. So this mechanical energy, it always happens through the rotating shaft against a load. Rotating shaft against a load, because this shaft which is coupled with the one end is coupled with the turbine. When it comes to in hydraulic turbines, the other end which is connected to the generator, right? So anyway, this mechanical energy, you know, that we can get from the rotating shaft, and here the stored energy. So it may be at rest, as it may be in motion when it is at rest. So here two energies are present. One is intermolecular energy, another one is potential energy. And when it is in motion, intermolecular energy, potential energy, kinetic energy, and pressure energies are present in the fluid in motion. So where the mechanical energy, you know, that we can get through the rotating shaft against a load. So this is about the small discussion on fluid machine. So I repeat again, so the fluid machine, it can convert stored energy in fluid into the mechanical energy, and also converts mechanical energy into stored energy in fluids, right? So here this stored energy, the nature is, when it is at rest, there intermolecular energy and potential energies are present, and when it is in motion, intermolecular energy, potential energy, kinetic energy, and pressure energy also present in fluid motion. So when it comes to mechanical energy, so the nature of the mechanical energy, so this mechanical energy we can get through the rotating shaft, and which is against a load. So this is about the small discussion on fluid machine. So let us have a classification of, let us have a discussion on classification of fluid machines. Classification of fluid machine. Then after, we'll continue with the hydraulic turbines. Classification of fluid machines. So here we have different classifications. So let me consider here in center. So from here I can classify very neatly. Now look at here the classification of fluid machines. So generally these machines, which are majorly classified into three different types, So here, majorly the fluid machines are classified into three different types. So here, one is direction of energy transfer. Next, the type of fluid used. And then principle. Principle of operation. So these are the three major classifications of fluid machines. So what exactly direction of energy transfer? So here in this, look at here fluid machine. So if it is converting stored energy in fluid to the mechanical energy, then we can call it as a turbine, right? And when it is converting from mechanical energy into stored energy in fluid, which is called pump. So here, this direction of fluids are two types. So one is direction of energy transfer. So if the stored energy is converted into mechanical energy, then we can call it as a turbines. And if mechanical energy is converted into stored energy, then it is called pumps. We can call compressors also. Fans and blowers. So I repeat again the direction of energy transfer. So if the stored energy, which is converting into mechanical energy, then we can call it as a turbines. And if mechanical energy is converting into stored energy, then it is a pump, compressor, fans, and blowers. So I have written very clearly. Look at here, if stored energy is converted into mechanical energy, then we can call it as a turbines. If mechanical energy is converted into stored energy, then it is a pumps, compressors, fans, and blowers. So these are the direction of energy transfers classifications. So next, classify the fluid used. So here, we have fluids are liquids and gases, right? So let me choose here. We have a fluid. Liquid and gas. So liquid means, for example, consider a water. So if it is a water, we can call it as a hydraulic turbines, right? So the fluid used, if we use liquid, then this hydraulic liquid is nothing but water. So this water energy is converted into mechanical energy, then we can call it as hydraulic turbines. Hydraulic turbine and mechanical energy into hydraulic energy, that is also related to liquid only, right? Then we can call it as pumps. So these are the two important topics that we have to discuss in this particular lesson, right? About hydraulic turbine and pumps. So our topic is hydraulic turbine. So where we are using the liquid as a water, and if that water energy is converted into mechanical energy, so that component is called hydraulic turbine. So hydraulic turbine can convert water energy into mechanical energy, and then pump, it can convert mechanical energy into water energy when we have a liquids. And when we have a gas as a source, then where we can, it can classified into air / gas turbines, compressors, fans and blowers. These are the few classifications, right? And principle of operations. So we have two different principles. One is dynamic action, another one is static action, right? So let me classify. It is taking time because, you know, one by one I am explaining and classifying here. So that is the reason it is taking some time. So here, if there is a dynamic action, dynamic action, then these are the rotodynamic machines. Rotodynamic machines, right? And if there is a static action, then it is a positive displacement machines. Positive displacement machines. So these are the classifications of fluid machines. So I repeat again. The fluid machines, which are classified into majorly three types. One is direction of energy transfer, another one is fluid used, and next one is the principle of operation. So direction of energy transfer. So if energy is transferring stored energy into mechanical energy, then we can call it as a turbines. If mechanical energy into stored energy, then we can call it as a pumps, compressors, fans, and blowers. If fluid, types of fluids used. If we are using a liquid, for example, water, then water is a hydraulic energy, right? So hydraulic energy into mechanical energy, that is called hydraulic turbines. Mechanical energy into hydraulic energy, that is called pumps. If we are using a gas, then where we have the air and gas turbines, compressors, fans and blowers. So principle of operations, if there is a dynamic principle, then we have a rotodynamic machines. And if there is a static action, a principle of operation, then we have a positive displacement machines. So these are the classification of fluid machines. Now in next class, we will have a clear discussion about what exactly hydraulic machine, classification of hydraulic machines. There is a power plant layout also, that is also we have to discuss, and different types of hydraulic turbines, right? So thank you very much.